Hey beauties, I bet you thought you were gonna get by this holiday season without having to host a party or make anything until you got that call from the relative you just can't say no to who says, can we please have the party at your place? Or you get a call from a friend saying, hey, can you bring an appetizer? We're asking everybody to bring a little something. Well, you're not gonna make a cheese plate. You're gonna make something a lot better. I have two food porn quality ideas that are super easy, meaning 2 to 3 ingredients, and they're delicious. And if everything works out, at the end of this video, my daughter and I will be sharing with you the activity to have if you're hosting a party that includes kids who are 8 years of age or old. And I'm not talking decorating sugar cookies. This is a lot more fun and a lot less sugar. Okay, beauties, so the first appetizer that I'm gonna share with you is the vegan or vegetarian appetizer. What you need for that are sweet potatoes, you need brown or white mushrooms, and you need pesto if you're doing the vegetarian version, because vegetarians usually don't mind if there's cheese. If you're doing the vegan version, you're gonna wanna get nutritional yeast to get that cheesy flavor, okay? Now, what you do first is that you're gonna wanna bake the sweet potatoes. You're gonna cut them in half. I'm sorry, but I don't have any that are raw. I use them all up. So you're gonna wanna cut them in half, put olive oil, salt and pepper, and put them face up to bake in your oven at 400 degrees for 40 minutes. While all of that is happening, what you're gonna do is that you are gonna take the mushroom, you're gonna take off the stem, and if you are making the vegetarian version, you are gonna take pesto. Depending on the size of the cavity inside, you're gonna take an appropriate amount of pesto. But I want you to get the small one so that this could really be something that you can just put in your mouth. If you're doing the vegan version, I suggest you put in some olive oil, just a tiny bit on the bottom. And then you're gonna do the same. You're gonna take a spoon, you're gonna fill up the inner cavity with the nutritional yeast. Now, once they're full like this, once your sweet potatoes are cooked, you can put all of these on a cookie sheet and you're gonna put them to broil at 450 for about 4 minutes. But depending on your oven, check to make sure, okay, before. Okay, beauties, next up is the other appetizer, which is for meat lovers. And now what you need are dates, and you're gonna need bacon, and basically you can just use those two things, or you can get a little crazy. And you can stuff the dates with blue cheese or with roasted salted almonds or pistachios or goat cheese or any other cheese that you want. All right, so all that you need to do is that you need to take the date, you need to take a knife, and you just cut it down the middle. Don't go all the way. You take out the seed inside, and next, all you have to do is you have to decide what are you gonna stuff it with. So if you wanna get crazy and you really wanna mix up all these tastes, you can put blue cheese inside of it, because like I said, this is food porn. And what you do is that right now you can see it's open. So you take a piece of blue cheese, you're gonna put it inside. What's great about dates is that you can kind of play with them. So look, I can squeeze it shut. Once it's like this and it's been stuffed, push it in, take your piece of bacon, and wrap it around securely. These you can actually put into the oven with the mushrooms. You can actually cook them at the same time on a roasting pan. And what you have to do, because these are a little bit longer, these are about, depending on the oven, it's gonna be 3 to 5 minutes each side on broil. Next, I'm gonna do one that is just, that doesn't have any cheese or almonds or pistachios inside. And what I like to do is that once it's open, kind of like, once it looks like Pac-Man, you know, what you can do is that you can take the bacon, stuff it inside, just the beginning of it, so that it looks like this is its tongue. Total food porn. And once it's there, just kind of squeeze the date together and then just roll it around. Okay, beauties, so once the mushrooms are done, all that you have to do is take a small leaf of baby spinach, put it on top of the mushroom. Take your sweet potato that you've cut into cubes, put it on top, and secure it with a toothpick. Here's the finished product. They're beautiful, they're delicious. You have something that can please vegans and vegetarians and the meat lovers and everybody in between.
I hope you guys enjoyed that.
Beauties, if you're seeing this part of the video, it means that I did not have time to share with you the activity that you need to have if you're hosting a holiday party that includes kids who are 8 years of age or older. So the idea comes from my daughter and all of her friends who say that decorating sugar cookies is totally out and that the end thing to do is to have the slime making station. So since I wasn't able to do the video with her, I'm at least going to provide for you a list of what you need to buy. And all that you need to do is just have a table for them available, a couple of Tupperwares or bowls and some plastic spoons, or just their hands usually is what they use to make all sorts of different slime. You're gonna wanna get glitter, like holiday colors, or you're gonna want shaving cream, you're gonna want glue, white glue or transparent glue or glitter glue. And basically the kids will do the rest. So I'll provide a list down below of everything that you need to create the most amazing slime station, so every kid will say, wow, her party, it was the best party ever. And what's great about this is that while the kids are busy creating gallons of slime, you will be free to talk with your friends and family. I hope you enjoyed this video, beauties. I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I can't wait to have more to share with you. If I do not make a video during the holidays, I wish all of you a beautiful holiday season. Love you.